welcome to Stantec. My name is Keita, and I'm an intern here in sustainable transportation. I'm also a fifth-year civil engineering student at the University of Alberta. I'm thrilled to be taking part in Science Expo today, and thanks for watching. And I had the opportunity one day to job shadow then Councillor Don Iveson. And it was a neat experience because he was in a council meeting that day where they were discussing whether or not to increase the budget made available for sidewalks and bicycle lanes in the city. I felt the need to kind of step up and say a couple words. So I got up and I talked about how I biked to and from school every day, high school every day, about 17 kilometers, and just what an incredible experience it is to be able to go through the Edmonton River Valley and just take in all of that nature every day. And that I thought if more investments were made in that same vein, we would be able to be a more sustainable city and also one that's more welcoming to youth. Mayor Mandel, he actually said right at the end, let's get it done. And then they voted on it and it passed unanimously to increase the budget from, I think it was like 1% of the transportation budget to 2%. Anyways, it turned out that one of the people who had been behind that plan was Dean Cooper, who it turns out is now my boss and my mentor here at Stantec. And I had actually met him at that meeting. He came up to me and sort of congratulated me on speaking to council. And I asked him if we could go for coffee, and he said yes. I think the main thing I want to point out there is that the extracurricular involvement of being at the Youth Council and getting involved in that way was what opened that door for me to then meet Dean and learn about careers in engineering. For me, the importance of education outside the classroom comes down to two things. I think the first one is expanding your knowledge base, and I think the second one is identifying and finding mentors who can help you develop critical skills for the area that you're interested in. Illustrate this through a sort of metaphor. It kind of takes me back to actually being in Pangnirtung, Nunavut, which is a community of 1,500 on Baffin Island. And I was working there last summer doing community drainage plans to adapt to climate change in the north. And one of the things that came up was that we needed to purchase some gravel to change some of the road configurations. And when that happened, I needed to actually go and measure this huge heap of gravel. It's about, if you take a bus and stand it on end, it was about that tall. I needed to go and measure the volume of this so we could figure out what it was going to cost. And then when I got to site, I was scrambling up this huge heap of gravel. And what I noticed is, every step that I took, the gravel was so steeply packed that it was falling down as beneath my footsteps as I was walking up this gravel heap. And I realized that gravel has a critical slope. So if you go above that slope, it becomes impossible to pile anything more on the top of the heap without it rolling down until that slope is restored. And so the metaphor that I like to make is that knowledge is like this too. I think that you can imagine the peak being like your passion. And I define a passion as being something that you really enjoy doing, intersecting with something that needs to be done. For me, one of my passions is bicycle infrastructure and bike lanes. And to know anything about bike lanes, you also need to know about related fields. So perhaps the bike lane crosses over a bridge. I need to know something about bridge engineering. Or perhaps I need to do community consultation and find out how to market the bike lane appropriately. Or I might be involved in the construction. I need to know about some of the asphalt materials that are being used. And so in that way, I think that the more that we try to become an expert in something, the more we need to diversify our knowledge base. So that's the first thing. The second thing is the converse. If you can imagine there being an abyss next to the pile of gravel, no matter what you try to do, putting more gravel on top, the gravel will simply fall into that abyss and disappear, and you won't make progress. And what I mean by an abyss is a critical skill that you need in order to achieve your passion that you haven't sufficiently developed. And so for me, I discovered that was writing skills. And in high school, I spent a lot of time reading books about writing, trying to think about logical thinking, looking at books that I liked and trying to analyze what was good about them. And that really helped me. But for each person, the challenge may be something different. It may be mathematical skills, it may be your ability to communicate in front of an audience. could be all sorts of different things, but building that solid platform is really important. And so just to give you an example of that, in high school, I went in, I remember I got something in the 60% for my first essay, and I was totally surprised because up until then, I guess my teachers had been going pretty easy on me. And that was the first thing that made me realize, oh, I've got this huge gap between where I need to be and where I am right now. And I worked at it, like I said. And in grade 12, I partnered up with a couple of friends, and we actually wrote a proposal to the Edmonton Transit System, asking them to put on an LRT dance party with us. So a dance party on a moving train. And that's the key piece, is we had to write a proposal for this. So it was a written piece of work. And the incredible thing was, I put a lot of time into editing it and trying to pare it down so it was as short and clear as possible. And they said yes. So it was incredible. One Saturday night in grade 12, over 100 high school students from across Edmonton came out, and we had our whole train outfitted with DJs, two different live DJs on each train car, all of these flashing lights and everything. We went up and down the train line for 2 hours, having this incredible dance party. And all of that became possible. Promoting sustainable transportation in that way became possible because of all of my teachers in high school helping me improve my writing and the mentors that I had met who had given me some very frank feedback about how to improve that critical skill that I needed to work on. So I think that's the second thing, is that extracurricular experiences give you opportunities to uncover skill sets that you need to work on. And they also introduce you to mentors and to people who can guide you in that process of giving you feedback and helping you to improve in those areas. I think mentorship is one of the most important things for students in STEM fields to be thinking about. It's incredible how, no matter what you study in school, when you get into the workplace, there's going to be totally different challenges that you're faced with. You need to be prepared to have somebody who you really trust, who you can ask questions and find out the information you need to know, so that you can learn about not only the work that you're doing, but also what sort of direction you'd like to take in your career and what sort of problems you'd like to be working on. I think that right now the educational model is designed around having one teacher and a lot of students. And the problem is that when you get into the workplace, it's much more of a one-on-one environment. The mentorship that I've had here at Stantec has been really good in the sense that I'm almost always getting individual time with someone where I'm getting personal coaching on how to improve the specific issues that I'm facing or the things that I need to work on. And very often the way that works is the person who's mentoring me will ask me a question that then makes me think about perhaps a flaw in my thinking or a flaw in the way that I was looking at something. And that's what really builds my ability then to work and ask those critical questions of myself, so that when I'm writing a report or I'm putting together a graph, I'm self-evaluating and being able to ask myself those questions about, would this really make sense when we're constructing it? Or would this design really be cost effective? The earlier you can get that started, the earlier you can meet somebody who's willing to spend time helping you understand the practice of their field. That really holds you in good stead for your career and also for your ability to contribute to the problems that the world is facing. I really think that for each individual, it's important to find your own path and to find which organizations really speak to you and then go and pursue those. But two that have been really impactful for me, one of them is Engage North and the other is DiscoverE, so I'll talk about those. Engage North is a program that started a couple years ago at the University of Alberta. And it's actually open to students from other universities as well. So it's a program that connects students in southern universities with Aboriginal and northern communities that are looking for specific expertise or specific work from students who are studying a particular subject area. So in my case, I went up there working on drainage plans because of my background in civil engineering. But there's a whole variety of projects, ranging from things in agriculture to community development. And so students who are studying all sorts of different fields can consider this program, and I'd highly recommend that you do. I think the second one I'd like to talk about is DiscoverE. And DiscoverE is a Faculty of Engineering Outreach program at the University of Alberta. There's very similar programs at many other universities, of course. And it's a great initiative in two ways, because it, first of all, enables university students to get some teaching experience and to reflect on their journey through the educational system up until that point. But it also gives the opportunity for youth in Alberta and the Northwest Territories to be exposed to a very passionate group of students. One more thing that I'd like to say about that is that I've reached out to a number of people over the years, including my boss now at Stantec, Dean Cooper. What I found is that professionals in a lot of different fields are incredibly willing to take their time and talk to you or even meet for lunch or coffee. And so I would say if there's people that you really admire in the field that you're passionate about, reach out to them. And Canada's a small enough country that no matter who you reach out to, if you write a really concise email that makes a good point, connects to them in some way, there's a lot of people who will write back and who will try to support you, and that's part of their mission. And getting that feedback and learning how to ask questions is a really important piece as well. So I would suggest if there's people that you'd like to reach out to, if there's people that you'd like to ask questions of and learn from, definitely do that. And if you don't hear back, that's happened to me too, you know, don't worry about it too much. They are very busy. Obviously a lot of people get, you know, hundreds of emails a day. But if you do hear back, it may be something that that really transforms your progression into your passion, your progression following your passion.